The things we used to do and used to be. I could be the one to make you feel that way. Be the one to set you free. Hey guys, welcome back to another Ipsy Glam Bag makeup tutorial. This one's a slash OOTD. By the way guys, don't you love this month's bag? It is so cute. Honestly, it's my favorite. Alright, so we're gonna get that flawless summer skin, and I'm gonna get that by using my airbrush machine. I just got this Temp 2 machine. I really like the coverage. I'm not into the finish, but good thing they have this powder that mattifies your face and locks in the makeup, so I'm good. After you've got that done, you're all ready to go. So let's go ahead and start on our eyes. Okay, so let's get our brows in shape. I'm using the NYX Cake Powder in Blonde, even though I'm not blonde. I just want my brows to be super natural. So I'm going to start off where they're most sparse, which is right at the point, and then I'm going to work out to the tail. It's okay, you can go a little heavier around this area just because your brows are probably a little thicker at the beginning. So you just want them to be really nice and balanced. You like my skinny mustache? I'm just kidding. So get a black eyeliner and line the upper waterline. And do you want to see how big my eyeball is? That's pretty big. So go ahead and line the lower waterline as well. Make sure it's nice and opaque. Alright, so I'm taking a small smudger brush and behind the counter, which is a really pretty taupe color, and I'm going to create a slight hazy shadow underneath my lash line. This is going to add depth to our eyes, and also it's going to be a base for our upside down smoky eye we're going to do. Next, I'm going to be taking Gerger, which is this really pigmented gold color from the Sephora 15th birthday palette, and I'm going to take it in the inner corners and then bring it underneath that hazy shadow we created underneath our eyes. I show you a little bit better on this side. It's just a little bit faster. Now we're going to take Smog from the Urban Decay palette. It's this really pretty bronze color, and we're going to work it on the outer corners of our eyes. Do you notice how your eyes look a little downturned? Isn't it crazy how shadow can just recreate your eye shape? Okay, so I'm going to take Foxy from the Urban Decay Naked palette and use it as a highlight to the lower part of our eyes and all over our lid as a base. Now I'm going to take this iridescent bluish brown eyeshadow from Bare Minerals and I'm going to put it in the center of the lower lash line. Always have a clean brush by your side. This is to ensure we don't have any muddy shadows and our shadow is nice and blended. So we're taking 1998, this glittery pigmented shadow. It is the prettiest purple, purplish pink I've seen. I really, really like it. And the color payoff is great. You're just gonna apply that all over your lid and then with a clean brush, go ahead and blend out the edges. I'm going to take behind the corner again and go ahead and darken the outer edges of your eye. And I don't know how many more clean brushes you have, but go ahead and take another brush, or it's at least a brush that has a really light color on it, and just go over that dark shadow so everything's nice and blended. This one is a multi-purpose, which I always love. What this is going to act as today is a brow bone highlight. Just pat it in with your ring finger and smooth it down into the other shadows. And then take another brush and blend in a little bit more of the behind the counter or a taupe color and blend it in nicely with a nice clean brush. Next, I'm going to be taking the Kaylin Cosmetics Line Fix Gel Eyeliner with a built-in brush. I have the purple one, and I'm going to just use it on the upper lash line and wing it out. It's really cool because it's highly pigmented, and it's waterproof, it's smudge-proof, which is great for summer. I always love a pop of color in the summer. Alright, it's time to perk up our lashes. We're going to put some mascara on and put some false lashes on. I like to put my lashes on with tweezers. What do you guys like to use? I always have to smudge them down and put them on with tweezers. Some people use Q-tips. I've seen people just use their hands. I can't do that. I need extra precision. And then I just kind of bend the eyelashes in so they can fit my eyes, and there we go. Now I'm going to take Paradise, this NYX blush, and apply it to my cheeks. I'm not going to apply it to my apples just because when you do it more to the center of your face, it makes you look a little older. So I like to keep it behind my apples. If you can see, I'll show you right now what I'm talking about. I like to stop it right there. I'm going to take this cute little buddy of mine and moisturize my lips. This is literally my favorite moisturizer. I've never tried EOS before. Obviously, I'm the last person on earth to do this or try it, but I love it. Then I just put on the lip gloss from Smashbox in a Lumi. Do you like it? Do you not like it? Oh hey, I just painted my first accent nail. Just don't look too close. Here goes a scary blooper that happened to me. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed making it for you. And I have a new little quote that I want to start telling you guys that I kind of created in my own head. I hope you find the beauty in something or someone new today. Until next time, bye dollies.